ายวิดีโอตัวขึ้นไปแล้วนะคะผู้ปกครองก็เริ่มทยอยมากันนะคะแต่ว่าเข้าห้องไม่ได้ประตูล็อกอยู่โอเคเราก็จะเข้าห้องประชุมนะคะนี่ก็คือ ISB TED Talk นะคะกว่าจะเข้ามาได้ขั้นตอนยุ่งยากมากส่วนใหญ่ก็จะเป็นพวกพ่อแม่เด็กกับเพื่อนๆ นะคะนี่ก็คือเวที TED Talk นะคะแต่ก็คือแบบปาตัว
นอนนอน
เดี๋ยวไปสัมภาษณ์บุญีกันโอเคมาดูคนสำคัญของวันนี้กันนะคะเท็ดทองนะคะดูสีเก้าอี้เว้นระยะหมดทุกตัวเลยค่ะเพราะฉะนั้นก็เลยคนเข้าได้ไม่เยอะนะคะบูมี่บูมี
่ You know what, in all seriousness, walking has an effect on all domains of our health. And so I thank you, Rina, so much for sharing that with you all.
Yeah, thank you, Rina.
You know, words matter.And as a running theme in our advisory, we've even talked about words and how it can affect those in the receiving end. And not only words, but labels, and the labels for our generation. Now, our next speaker, Bloomy, is going to give us a different take on this word, snowflake, and how it harms discourse and helps progress. Please welcome Bloomy on stage.
You've instantly associated me with about a million more. And chances are you've associated me with the label of just another oversensitive, easily offended, triggered Gen Z. Sound familiar? Well, an oversensitive, easily offended, triggered Gen Z is synonymous with the term snowflake. The term snowflake is used as a political insult to call someone oversensitive, usually directed at millennials and Gen Zers with more liberal political views. So maybe you would call me a snowflake, because I am offended. But today, instead of telling you what I'm offended about, I'm going to tell you why. And why it is okay, great even, for me to be offended. Hi. My name is Bloomy Leung Utai, and this is the snowflake phenomenon. Our society is moving towards a culture of both hypersensitivity and hyperapathy. And what this means is that the more one group cares about something, the more their opposite team retaliates with complete ignorance. And nowhere can we see this clearer than with political correctness. To be politically correct is to use language that is the least offensive as possible.Especially when referring to certain groups, like certain races, ethnicities, genders, or sexual orientations. It's someone saying partner instead of husband or wife to avoid assuming anyone's sexuality, or using the term non-disabled instead of able-bodied to be more inclusive to the community. It's all about changing the way you speak and the language that you choose to use to be more inclusive and mindful to how other people might feel.Political correctness strives to address the microaggressions embedded in our language today. A study done by Fortune magazine on 4,275 Americans in the workplace found that 60% said that they had witnessed or potentially witnessed microaggressions, where 7 in 10 said that they were uncomfortable witnessing it.
gentlest rain that falls softly on the meadow. Birds high upon the trees serenade the clouds with a melody. Oh, oh, see. Stay for us, just to fall in love. You hold me in your arms and say once again you love me. And if your love is true, everything will be just as wonderful.
ภูมิถ่ายเดี๋ยวรูปหนึ่งมา